Sinners in the hands of a sovereign God, we're looking at why bother with baptism? Why bother with something as seemingly insignificant and optional as baptism? With all the pain and suffering in the world, with all the things that we should be attending to, why stop and be baptized? Why should a believer in Jesus be baptized? Baptism is one of the most misunderstood and mistaught practices in the Bible. I mean, think about it. What have you been told or taught regarding baptism? What have you been told or been taught regarding believers' baptism? What have you been told or been taught about, hey, you don't need baptism to go to heaven? And how has that either helped you or hindered you in your Christian life? Or have you ever given it a second thought? I mean, baptism is one of those things where people really don't think about it. And there's a lot of wacky ideas about it. Oh, baptism saved me from my sins. Wrong. Oh, when I got baptized, now I'm in the body of Christ. Wrong. No, when you come to faith in Christ, you are saved by grace through faith alone, in Christ alone. But you are to be baptized. And here's what I said on Sunday that I actually hope that it was actually a really eye-opening thing to you, okay? That there are a lot of baptized believers. Thumbs up for you, okay? You're not getting the, you're getting the, way to go. Good job. Baptized believers growing in Christ. But there are a lot of unbaptized believers. That's disobedience to Christ. You need to get baptized if you're a believer. And then there are baptized unbelievers. You're blinded to Christ. You got baptized and you have a false hope. You need Jesus, not baptism, to get to heaven. But it is absolutely valid to ask, with all the suffering in the world, with all the death and devastation and destruction, and the suffering that sinners put upon sinners, why bother with something as seemingly ridiculously optional as baptism? Again, at Grace Orange, we baptize people. We baptize believers in Jesus who have a testimony. We just had a baptism a couple weeks ago at the beach. Why did Jesus choose baptism as the first step of obedient discipleship? Here's the premise. This is the point. Baptism is essential. Not to get to heaven, not for justification, but for sanctification, for your obedience to Christ. And the four reasons I gave on Sunday was this. First, because God made you his. God chose you before the foundation of the world, and God made you his. You belong to him, so now you are to do what his people do. Secondly, because God commands it. He made you his and he commanded it. Believer's baptism is essential, not optional, because it is commanded. And if you can disobey this command, what other commands of God can you be willy-nilly about and say, you know, I don't think I need to obey that? Think about it. If you can't obey this first unoptional command, then which other commands might you think that you don't have to obey? Okay, and by the way, I put that on church leadership, pastors and elders like myself that maybe don't let people know often enough, hey, if you're a believer, you need to get baptized, okay? So because God made you his, because God commands it, and because God is pleased with it. Third, he is pleased when you obey him. There are blessings with obedience. There are consequences for disobedience. So because God made you his, because God commands it, because God is pleased with it, and lastly, number four, because God uses it, it speaks loudly to all. It is a testimony of faith in Christ. Sinners in the hands of a sovereign God, we ask the question in light of God's sovereignty, why is it so important to be baptized in obedience to Christ? And it is because God made you his, and he commanded it, and he is pleased with obedience. And because he uses the testimony of believers for his glory and your good, he uses the gospel being preached, because when someone stands up to get baptized, they give a testimony of their faith in Christ. Now, the Bible, the New Testament, someone would believe and be baptized right away. So Lydia, we gave this example on Sunday. In Acts chapter 16, Lydia, God opened her heart to pay attention to what was said by Paul. She believed the gospel, and after she was baptized. And then the Philippian jailer, what must I do to be saved? Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved. And then he was baptized at once, he and all those who had believed. You'll notice, go back to the sermon on the day of Pentecost in Acts chapter 2. What did Peter say to the people? He said, repent, right? And be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ. Turn from your sins. And it says, he says, save yourselves from this crooked generation. So those who received his word were baptized and were added that day about 3,000 souls. This harkens back to Matthew 28, when Jesus says, all authority on heaven and earth is given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I commanded you, baptism being the first thing commanded, and lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. So baptism is essential, not for justification, not to get to heaven, but for sanctification, for God's glory and your good. If you're a believer, go get baptized. If you're already a believer that's been baptized, encourage other believers to be baptized and keep preaching the gospel of the grace of God in Christ. Keep proclaiming your testimony of faith in Christ and what Jesus means to you every day of your life. Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for your word. Thank you, Lord, that you enable our glad obedience, and we gladly obey you. We want to obey you. I pray for any believers that heard this that aren't baptized, that they would run to their Bible-based church led by a plurality of elders that are preaching the word and doing the Lord's Supper and baptism and church discipline and outreach, and that they would go and get baptized right away. And that, Lord, people that you've opened their hearts to believe the gospel, that please help your church practice baptism as biblical as we can, as often as we can, as soon as possible after conversion, all for your glory. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.